so we made it to the garden center. We're gonna be working on a box lid. So far, we just pulled out the weeds, cleaning up the base of it, and then we're gonna get into the trimming of it. Sometimes I like to keep the moss, put that back into the tree. We brought the tools and a notebook, so we'll keep you guys up to date with it. That's a tree that we're gonna be working off with this video.
Right back.
Right.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they'll grow small, but they're plenty.
I heard months, it was just fly growing everywhere. Like, that's why they like the sunlight. You need it. Wholesome growth. Great
salivary.
That's what I've noticed. try to record this?
Cyber logging. Some people wouldn't like, this is a granted tree, I think, and some people wouldn't like that. Now,
for me, stuff like that is just character, and, you know, that's what I look for stuff like that. Here's a root come along, that one is exactly the way you want it,
but then it has good roots over here. Start cleaning it out, and you're starting to see it's got some really nice roots over here.
Oh, yeah.
See that? That's
it. It's kind of nice how it wraps around.
Yep. And it's nice. The flow of the roots is going this way, and the flow of the tree is going that way, keeping the balance and the harmony of it.
And beautiful.
Yeah, this is. I saw this tree. I was like, I gotta have it.
Honestly. And it has a lot of branches to work with.
And, I'm not sure how this one actually grows, but I can include here when I look at a tree I don't know about. And I'll look at the natural branch structure. Look here, you see here, it's like all these branches coming off. So that's a good sign that it'll ramify. So this tree, I'll be able to make it ramify. And if you look in here.
What does that mean?
Ramifying is the branch structure.
The branch structure? Okay.
All right, well, let me start with that.
Oh, that's the one that you sent me.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a picture.
No, not at all. I showed my parents that. They're like, that part looks amazing.
Right, so a little bit of
things.
This face where the see this one I've neglected. You don't want to do. This is a good example of what not to do. Let the moss grow up on the tree. So.
Doesn't that create like root rot or something?
Yeah, it starts rotting the bark, and then it gets not root rot, but it'll start rotting the bark. But this has some deadwood in it anyway, which is fine by me.
Adds character.
Yeah. So with this, you want to leave, and this part down here is called the nabari, and that's where the cream of the thing is. And then you have a main trunk, and this would be in a broom style. These would all be branching. Then you would call these secondary branching, and then out here are the twigs.
These are the secondary branching?
No, that's a twig.
Okay.
A twig is this year's growth, and you can see where it started there, and you see there's no interruption. I mean, there's a little bit here, but that was probably during the summer. And but this.
That's the secondary branch.
Right, that's a secondary.
Okay,
branch.
And this is primary.
And that's a primary. Okay. Here. So you go by year, like 1 year, you know, this. Here, well, let's start this way. It's like this is a twig, which is this year's growth. Last year's growth is the secondary branch, and then the primary branch is down in here.
Oh, okay.
So that's what you're trying to do. This one's starting to get on its way for getting the ramification. The ramification is this, where the twigs. And you see how it's starting to fill out a little more. And, you know, this is not quite there yet. More years.
When they lose, it's okay if they lose all those.
Oh, yeah.
For any of them?
Well, these are supposed to.
Oh.
But this one, not necessarily.
If that one loses all its leaves, it'll die.
Yeah.
Okay.
But that's an evergreen. And this is deciduous tree, which this time of year is a little nice.
What species is this?
Katsura. Yeah, I like. No, not the moss. This moss is good.
Yeah,
this helps retain moisture, and it's nice one.
bone starts growing on the tree.
Yeah, this moss is not good.
So that's a different type of
moss.
Yeah,
it's really coarse. And bone say you try to find the fine looking. I mean, this is coarse. You can use it, but, you know, I really need to clean this off. Don't start losing bark. It's got such a good nib. It's hiding in the bark. If you look, see where I'm scraping it away?
Yeah.
You see all that nice Nabari in there? I mean, this got really good Nabari. You can see I'm hiding it.
Tell over here also that it's coming out. The moss is hiding it.
Yep. The moss, so that, you got to clean that all out. This is one example of not what not to do.
Don't let the moss grow like that.
Right.
Okay.
And you can either just, like, I usually just scrape it off. Some people use vinegar to kill moss. But
wouldn't that harm the tree also?
It could. That's why.
I wouldn't do that.
Some people take, sometimes even Roundup or vinegar, and they'll just dab it, when the tree's dry, so the moss grabs that right there, but not enough to let it go down. And then after the moss starts dying, then you want to water it real good to flush everything out. But this one, when I start digging here, this really has a nice Nabari. I mean, really. I remember this tree when I got this tall.
Dang.
It looked like this. But then what impressed me was that I got it out of one of the yards when I was left on money. Big one, and it was growing in the flower bed. Yeah. And I said, "Can I have it?" And when I pulled it out, it just had a flat root system. It was growing on top.
Perfect. Well, that's perfect.
It was a piece of slate.
If I had some good root flare.
And it just made it just super flat. You can see how flat that is.
And that was this tree?
This tree. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. And I mean, I was so lucky with that. And I have another one. These roots are like easily too. I got a bunch of these that started. So yeah, that's so you know about the plant structure. And this is rambling, like on the pine tree. There's main branches, and then secondary, and then here is really wouldn't call them twigs, but they're finer branches.
That's some beautiful.
That's a whole another class on developing these.
This is the wire stone. That's why wiring the tree in.
Yeah, the wire. You always want to wire the tree into the pot.
So this is forever tied to one pot.
As you go along, you can change the pot. This tree gets repotted probably every 4 or 5 years. It's a faster growing tree. This one gets repotted probably 8 to 10 years. You don't want to repot too often. When I start watering it and the water isn't going right through, then it's time to pot. If you repot it too often, some trees act negatively to being repotted and some just grow and grow. Crab apples. You repot them, they just and that's, you don't want that.
No.
So, but you have to repot them every once in a while. So if you let them go too far and get pot down, then they'll die.
What about like the younger trees whose roots are still growing like pretty vigorous, and you try and grow them bigger? Wouldn't you want to repot those more as they outgrow the container?
Right.
Okay.
Yeah, and you generally will grow it in a bigger container. This pot pretty good for this tree. I mean, a lot of broom styles will have a round pot, but I happen to like this pot, and I think it complements the trunk on that tree, and the branching, so I really like that one. This contains, enough here, so it has enough room to keep it sustained and everything. Just smaller pots, you gotta water them a lot.
Yeah.
So, like the Japanese, a lot of times, will have really small pots, and that's they're taking care of them. You know, they might need 3
day, every day.
And
I know exactly.
Yeah, for shows, sometimes they'll actually rent pots.
because
no ramp pods.
Yeah, the pots they use for shows are like ancient pots that are worth, you know, thousands of dollars, and they don't want to invest all that. So there's people that rent these pots.
Okay, and they get them just for the show, and then they okay.
So they'll grow them. We'll transplant them. We'll usually start 2 years before the show.
So it takes time to develop in there.
Right.
And they can
take care
without harming the tree.
As soon as the show's over, they come out of that pot.
Yeah. Interesting.
Do you prepare 2 years in advance for a show?
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah.
It's the process.
Yeah, this one I'm planning on showing this tree in 4 years.
Okay.
I'm gonna try to get it into the Rochester Nationals, and I think. I have not seen any petsoras up there at all.
Oh, really?
So
it'll be the first one.
If I can develop this nicely, in 4 more years, I can really, if I really work on it.
4 years, you can change the transition of that real quick.
Yep.
Well, not real quick, but.
Are they like in categories by tree type?
Yeah.
You'd be like the winner.
They have a best in show, and then they have other awards they give out. It's just neat. And I didn't see any pet sorters up there at all.
That's a perfect one.
There's a lot that has to be done to this tree to make it ready. But I think it can be.
Definitely.
Like a lot of stuff here, when I'm cutting these off, I'll leave a knob like this.
For dieback? Or for deadwood?
Yeah, no. You don't usually make deadwood in
this kind
of, but this will be cut off here. Probably next spring, I'll cut that off. Because I let them die off.
And then you cut it.
Right, then you cut it. Because a lot of these deciduous...
Similar to a maple.
Right, yeah. And maple, too, you want to do that.
I don't want to do that, no.
Because then what'll happen is if you cut it flush, then it might start dying down on the trunk. So this way you have this, and this dies down, and then you can see where the live wood is here. So now that I know that's where the live wood is, next spring when I cut it, I'll know where to cut it. I'll just cut it right on that. Cut paste to put on that. So, yeah, there's a few minor tweaks just have to go through and get a little more ramification and everything. And this is a nice tree too, but it's the branch structure as far as the show tree, it's not really there. I mean, I've had them a long time, but a lot of my clients are not. I'm slowly getting
it's your
back.
Show tree.
Okay?
It's your show tree.
Yeah. And,
as long as you enjoy the show.
Oh, yeah. And, because I went through a period where about 5 years where I didn't do anything to my trees. I just let them grow.
Okay.
Yeah, I went through a big life change, and I just got to be secondary, but I managed to keep most of them alive.
Right on.
It was exasperated by I had a major kill off. I lost half of my trees.
Dang, that's probably devastating.
I had a Japanese white pine that was worth it. Lot of money, and they just did not make it through that. We had, I just moved up to the mountains up here, and we had all ice. We didn't have any snow, just all ice, and then we had a week of 25 below at night.
Dang.
And even though it was in the shed, it just, all my
dang.
More tender, but this survived it, and that survived it. But a lot of
those
trees,
are the only two that survived?
No.
Oh, okay, just the two.
I have a bunch that survived it. I'll show you.
Yeah.
But these, so I'm slowly trying to get these back. But something like this it would really never be a show tree. But it's
something that like you can enjoy though.
Yeah, oh yeah.
100%.
Oh,
definitely.
Yeah.
And to grow and just care for and train it.
Yeah.
Not every tree is supposed to be a show tree. That's why you got the specific ones that are.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I got a lot.
Oh, yeah.
So that's basically.
Now, I got a quick question.
Yeah.
When training for bonsai, can you train them to like a small bonsai pot and grow the bonsai pot as it grows, or is it better to have start growing in like one of these pots and then bring it down to the bonsai?
There's a lot of people that won't do heavy pruning on a tree. They say, oh, that's not a bonsai. When you can act those two trees, that cat Soro is probably 6 foot tall.
Dang! Okay. Yeah, that's kind
of... Some people's like, oh, that's not a bonsai.
Yes, it is.
But it'll take a
tackles. I mean, it takes a long time.
Yeah.
But, you know, that's what they like to do. So, yeah, there's different
ways. I like having it halfway started.
Yeah. I could find a branch we kind of go up more, like this one here. See, these trees are nice and flexible. But if you look in here, you'll see how the collar of the thing is at an angle. So that tree, this branch, could go up like that.
Mm.
So what I'll do, I was thinking about this one too, this little branch. That could work, or this one. But this one is actually better because the collar is pointing more up. This one, you see how it's pointing straight across?
Yeah.
I mean, the branch going straight across from there. So what I'll do is I'll this part is actually what is actually killing it. That's all going to be, you know, eventually.
Okay.
So, I'll do next. I feel nice. What I'm doing right here is I'm just pulling the top.
Yeah, it does. It's almost like a minty smell.
This is the outer bark. You see here this white stuff? That's the inner bark. And this here is what they call the secondary xylem, which is wood. So you have a xylem and phloem, which transport water and fertilizer and stuff, chemicals up and down through the tree and the water. And then when it uses it up, that's where the rings come in. When you see rings on a tree, that's where it's dying back. And the xylem, the phloem actually, is dying off and leaving that ring. And the xylem is separating with it. And the xylem continues to transport water.
So this wood here is actually, when it's alive, it's transporting water. So now we're killing that off. So, you know, I want to scrape it down as much as I can, just to the... And this is what you can call a gin. It's when you, it's all dead wood. And this is how you make gins. Now this tree, I really don't want a thick gin on it, so... Step I would do. Gin sliders?
That looks real nice.
Yeah. So when this dries out, you can either use lime sulfur.
Okay, so that's that stuff that normally, okay.
I like using latex house paint, I mean stain, solid stain, and I just, that way you can get different colors.
Oh, that's kind of nice.
Because if you put the lime sulfur, this will just kind of turn white, and to me, that a lot of that doesn't look natural.
No.
So, especially for the, out west, yeah, that's kind of natural in some areas, but out east, that's not natural.
Yeah, that's neat.
And what I'll do is I'll take this branch and wire it up here. I don't really need to wire this trunk, it's already
got a good movement.
It's got good movement. So then I'll come down here.
And would you cut off some of these dead branches or leave those?
Oh, yeah.
Cut those all off?
Yeah, that's what the next step will decide to clean it up.
For that to die, and then after it died, then you cut it?
Yep. Or you can make a little gin if you really want to.
Oh. Okay. Yeah, because on that One Fall Cypress that we first worked on over the phone, it has like some parts on that that I thought about doing that too, because I feel like that would make it look kind of neat.
Yep. So then you gotta look for a first branch. Now I'm looking at this tree, you've got these branches, you see how skinny they are?
Yeah.
You look up here and you see these big branches?
Get rid of the thicker ones.
Because you want the branches to be thicker, lower,
and thinner,
smaller as they go up. So these thick ones.
Thicker on bottom and thinner on top.
third